Morning, guys. Wanted to come on here and do this quick makeup look. I was actually not going to do one. I thought, you know, I'm going to take a break today, but I decided to just do it and get dressed. I didn't want to be in my vata. I said no. I set a goal that I need to take care of myself and look and feel better. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this makeup look for you guys. So I was thinking what to wear. Haven't bought a bunch of like clothes in such a long time, so I'm just wearing this green shirt that I've had for years, and I was kind of feeling like doing something green. So hopefully you guys will like the makeup look. Yesterday I did blue, the day before I did like a Harley Quinn inspired, and the day before that I think I did like a maroon because I was wearing a maroon dress. So today I'm going to do something green. I have a lot of like solid clothing. I don't really buy like a lot of patterns. So yeah, I don't know. It's just how I've always been. If I do get like some patterns, I do like the lines across, or... yeah, I'm not really one to buy like a bunch of patterns and stuff. Anyway, so I put some music in the background just to have some noise. I did take out this set. This is some costume jewelry, just some fashion jewelry that my sister gave me several years ago and I've never worn. And I'm really going to just use it for the makeup look so you guys could kind of see it a little bit more put together kind of a look. When I used to work at the nursing home, the girls would always get really nicely done up. They would always like, I mean, you had to go nicely dressed to the nursing home because the girls were always looking so beautiful and stuff. And so, especially my supervisor. We worked in medical records, and so she always was always dolled up, you know. She used to work at Bell's, and she would always, you know, just have all like the latest clothing and jewelry and all that stuff. So I knew I had to step up my game. So that's pretty much where I started learning that, hey, you know, you got to get a little bit more dolled up. And so then I had lost like 30 pounds, and then I just ended up, you know, doing more for myself. And so that's how I feel right now. Because I've been losing some weight, I actually feel better about myself, so I want to do a little bit more for myself. So anyway, I took out this fashion jewelry, not to say costume jewelry, fashion jewelry, and you'll see it. It's really, really beautiful. At first when I saw it, I was like, oh, it's too much, because I hadn't been doing any of that. I haven't, like, dolled up like that. And so I was like, no, I like simple stuff right now. She's like, no, it looks pretty on you. So I was like, okay. So I haven't used it, so I'm going to try it on so you guys can see it after the makeup look, and hopefully we have a pretty makeup look. I'm even going to do my hair for you guys. I'm actually going to straighten it out and everything because this is just freshly washed. And yeah, so we're going to go ahead and start. I went ahead and took out a few makeup palettes. You guys know I always try to show you guys what I took out. I did use these in the past videos. I used this one right here from Too Faced and this one right here from Too Faced. I love these two palettes. But I also did take out this Vice palette. I don't know if you guys even remember this palette. This is a really old palette. I don't even know if anybody has it anymore, but I still have it. And you guys can see, like, I have used some of it, but not enough. So I really took it out for this green right here. Because I didn't have a ton of green eyeshadows, and so I hadn't shown you this palette. This was a gift from my sister as well. So I'm going to go ahead and do a makeup look. I actually got this for Christmas some years back. Okay, so you guys know I'm going to use green. I like to coordinate with my clothing, and so I'm going to go ahead and do that. But I'm also going to coordinate with this fashion jewelry. So it's got some gold in here. But I might add some of that gold and probably some browns, and we'll see how it all turns out. Okay. Hold on real quick, guys. Let me just switch the music here. I don't know what happened. Something else came out. And then the ads on YouTube come out, and then we have some crazy stuff going on in the background. So, yeah. Let me switch it up because... We're gonna put some Spanish music. Okay. Anyway. Let's go ahead and start. We're gonna go ahead and use this 120 because I told you I have to use this up. I haven't finished it yet, so. And I think I'm actually gonna have to repurchase. I have the 122, but I really like the way the 120 is looking on me so far. But yes, we're gonna want to use this foundation. If I run out, which I think I'll be fine, I have the 122. I took out the wedges, I took out the Jane bronzer, and I took out this blush that was so pretty yesterday. So I took those out. I did take out some new lipstick products. So I took out this one, and honestly I don't know what brand this is, but I know that this is from Sephora. And they have this Avon lipstick, which is like a purple lipstick, and I'm not even sure if I'm gonna want to use it, but it's like a really dark, like burgundy purpley shade, so we'll see. And if not, we'll just do some nudes. Okay, that's just how we're gonna do it. I took out the e.l.f. blush just to top it with that other e.l.f. cream. Every time I'm gonna do a video, somebody calls. Anyway, okay, let's go ahead and start. I have makeup wedges. Hopefully the music is not too loud in the background. I have like three. So we'll just go ahead and start. Happy Tuesday, guys. Hopefully you guys are having a good morning. Let's see if we can take out some. Yeah, we'll have enough. See? We have enough. I always put it on my hand. So I'm going to apply this here. You guys know the drill. I never prime or put moisturizer because I break out. My face has been doing really good even though I've been wearing makeup daily. Kind of worried if I started doing these kind of videos if I was going to start breaking out. But actually that Panoxyl is doing really, really well for me. I just got my son to start using it. And he's actually really liking it. I started him on the 4%, and then I recently bought like the 10%. Luckily our Walmart had it, so I bought it. And I told him to start with the 10% once a week, but he seems to be wanting to use it daily, so. But he only uses it at night. I told him, you know, start off slow at first because it does dry out the skin a little bit. Not like where it's unbearable, but you can feel the tightness at first. So he's doing well with it. I see his face is clearing up. Okay. So you can see how beautiful this foundation goes on. Just making sure everything is nice and covered. We're going to add a little bit more. You guys know I like to add a little bit more here and here. Just so I make sure that all the pores are covered really well. I think I might have like maybe two or three more uses out of there. It seems like it still has a little bit. I thought I was going to run out, but. So we're just adding some extra product right here for the pores. And then right here. And whatever's left on this sponge is what we use to clean up. I love this foundation. I hope they never discontinue it because they did a really great job with it. Okay. So that is our base. And let me just look in my magnified mirror, make sure everything is nice and blended. It looks good. Yeah, it looks good. Okay, So we're going to start with the brows. You guys know I start with the brows. This is the e.l.f. brow pencil. We're going to start here. And we're just going to make what seem to be hair. So like that. And then go across. And then down like this. And then at the top, like that. Okay, so we already have one brow done. I like the way that one looks. This is the one we always have trouble with, but you can actually see the difference. See? We're not doing anything too crazy and super dark. We're just kind of just filling in a little bit because they're too light. Once you add the foundation and all that, they just kind of like lose color. And so we want to add some color back to the face. And go here at the top. So just kind of measure right here, make sure they're like the same size. I feel like that's good. I'm happy with that. Like that. And then just gonna brush them real quick. I don't want to lose the color, so I'm just going to brush them real quick. Up. And like that. Okay. So that's good. I like the way that looks. I'm going to go ahead and keep it like that. And we'll just go ahead and start with the eyeshadows. I know that that's what takes the longest. And then I will do the contouring and all that other stuff. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and start with, I had to take out this one because I think that it has such beautiful browns in this palette. I just recently saw another one in Sephora and it's just so beautiful. And I wish I could, I wish I could purchase it. This one I went ahead and took out because of the green in the palette. This is the one we used, I believe, yesterday or the day before. This is the green in this palette. So this one is really pretty, and I really liked it because of the gold. And since the fashion jewelry has some gold, I wanted to incorporate some of that somehow. So we're going to go ahead and start. I'm trying to look for a good matte to look, to put on. And honestly, I think this is the only palette that has the transition shades that I need instead of this one. I don't really like the browns for this look. I like the browns in the palette. I just don't like it for this look. I kind of am trying to maybe do this one as a transition shade. Hopefully it's not too dark. This one is a little bit lighter, but I kind of want to do this one. Okay, and you always want to use like a matte as a transition shade. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and do that. And let me get some brushes here. I took out more brushes and I also took out some green liners, so I'll show you those in a little bit. Okay, so we're gonna go back to this brush right here. You always want it to be like a fluffy brush. I also have like a Real Techniques brush. I love using this brush, so if you have like a brush like this, this one's actually really good too. So I might even use this one right now, just so I can show you, because I've been showing you this one a lot lately. So if you get your hands on this Real Techniques one, this one's actually really good. So it's got a little bit of eyeshadow on there. That's what I'm trying to dust off a little bit. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and use this one so you can see the difference. We're going to go into this color right here. You want to tap off the excess because that one does kick off a little bit. of excess. We're going to just add a little bit more of the foundation here. Make sure there's no creasing. Great. We're going to go ahead and start. Top off all the excess. Got some on there. And you're going to see how fast this one does the job because it's bigger. See? The other one's good too. As you can see, I've been doing the makeup looks with that. But I like this one because I can get in here really well. So this is a little bit of a darker shade than I would normally use for a transition, but it's a beautiful shade. It doesn't look as dark on camera, but when you see it in person, it's a little bit darker. Okay, so we're going to do the side. I'm actually going to have to use my camera as my mirror because I want you guys to see what I'm doing. Added some more on the brush. Usually, like I said, the transition shades need to be lighter. So like you could do something like this, but I want to intensify it a little bit more. So I'm going a little bit darker. Because the green is so intense, I kind of want to make it like a really bold look. Okay, so I have my transition shade down. And I like the way it looks. So we're going to move on to the next shadow. Okay, so I'm going to put this one aside. And I kind of like both greens, but I'm going to try... sorry if you hear that. That's my chair. Okay, the green in the Vice palette is more similar to the color that I'm wearing, but I really like the dark one in the Too Faced palette. So I might use the darker one on the lower lash line area, and I'm going to use the green one on the lid and just see how that goes. If not, I will add a little bit of the dark one out here. Okay, so let's see. Let me show you. I'm going to swatch it. This is the color on the Vice palette. So let's go ahead. I never plan these videos, guys, so I don't know exactly how it's going to turn out. Hopefully it turns out good and it's not too crazy. But I kind of want to do, I guess what they call a halo effect, where you put green here and green here and then like a gold, kind of like what we did yesterday. So I think that's what I'm going to do. And hopefully it comes out good. I could also do like just straight across and then just do the gold right here. But I think I want to do the halo effect and hopefully it looks good. If not, we can always cover it up and just work with it. So we're going to add this green right here. And this is a really beautiful green. And we're going to add some on this side. Like that. Do some green on this side. But you want to leave the center. I should use my other finger for this, but hold on, guys. I have the music going, and I don't know. Something else started playing. Okay, so I need to add a little bit more on this side. Like this. And we're just leaving the center. We're leaving it alone. And I didn't bring a towel again to clean off my fingers. So let me see. Let me go see if I can get one. Hold on. I hate it when I don't bring, I forget. See, I try to grab everything and I just Okay, so here's this perfume also, and I just got a little towel. Okay, so let's go ahead and add the gold in the center, and hopefully it looks good. We're going to go ahead and take this palette now, okay, and we're going to go into that gold, and we're going to go ahead and add it in the center. I hope this comes out good. We're just going to go up a little bit higher. And we are going to have to add some dark shadow just to kind of make it come together. Because just like this, it looks a little, you know. So we still need some more color on here for sure. And I'm going just a tiny bit higher because when you open up your eyes, it kind of will go up there anyway. So you want to go up a little bit higher, okay? Like that. And I'm going to add some more green, but I'm going to go in with a brush. Like that. Like that, okay? And then I'm going to take a brush now, and I'm going to add some with the brush. Because we want to, I brought this brush out. I was using this one with my face paints with my kids when I would do the face paints for them. This is the brush I would always use. That's why it's got crazy colors on there. Okay, so we're going to go back into that Vice palette and get some of the green. And we're going to put some green on here. Tap off the excess. We don't want all that crazy green on there. And we're just going to get all the little corners. Okay. You want to get all the little corners. Like this. And kind of just blend it into that gold. This, and we're going to add that really pretty dark shade right here, so it'll just bring everything together. So don't worry about that. We're going to go over here like this, and then go to the other side, and then just connect everything and try to bring it into the gold a little bit. And we're going to add some more gold just so everything blends together. We're going to do this with the finger. And then just blend it all. Like this. Okay, so now we need like a darker shade to kind of just bring everything together, because right now it looks a little off. So we definitely need to add like a darker shade just so everything looks better together. Okay, so for that I'm going to do a brown, and it has to be a matte. You don't want to do any shimmer on the crease. You want to do a dark shade. So I have some really beautiful dark browns, which are in this palette right here, and they're so beautiful. So I want to use both of those. I'm definitely going to use both of those. Let me just move you just a tiny bit, guys. I need some room here. So for this, I need a crease brush. So I like to use this e.l.f. one. Let me see if I brought any others so I can show you some other ones that you could actually use. You could use something like this as well. You can use something like this, like the Wet n Wild one. But I like to use the one from e.l.f. So just to clean it up real quick. It had some black in there. We don't want any of that black on there. At least not right now. I don't know if I'm going to use black today. I might. I'm not sure. But let's go into the darkest brown, which is this one right here. Okay? And then I'm going to add some of this one on there. So I'm going to add the dark one first. And I'm going to tap off all the excess because it does kick off a lot of excess. And then we're just going to go here to the crease. We're going to start with this eye. And I need my magnified mirror for this because I need to see better. And here's where you just want to kind of connect everything. Like this. And we're going to do this side now. And we're going to connect. And we're going to go all the way into that, like, gold. All the way to the top of that gold. Like that. I know it's still looking a little crazy, but it's going to come together. Just watch. And we're going to tap off the excess. We're going to add a little bit more. We're going to go into that gold like that. And same on this side. Like that. Okay, so just trust the process, guys. We're going to clean off the brush with the towel. Just make sure you get it all off. And I'm going to go into the lighter brown. So we used this brown. Now we're going to go into this brown, which is a little bit like of a little bit more red. Okay. And tap off all the excess because it kicks off a lot. They're beautiful shadows to work with. Just because it kicks off eyeshadow doesn't mean it's a bad eyeshadow. Okay, so here we go. We're going to go up here now with that shade and just lightly, like just barely touch the skin. Okay, and we're going to add some like that. And then we're going to add on this side because it still has a lot of product on there. And since we're going to blend, we need a lot of that product to come off. So, okay, like that, like that. Now, whatever's left on the brush, do not add any more product, okay? You're just going to go ahead and kind of go up a little higher, okay? We're going to go higher. So just lightly touching the skin, like barely touching the skin. You want to go up there and just blend. You want to just blend all these browns. See how it's kind of like blending? And we're going to do this side now. I forgot to actually use my little pen to kind of take off all the little hairs on my brows. So I'm going to do that in a little bit. Because that does bother me. There's a lot of blending that still needs to be done. Okay, but so far, this is what it's looking like. And we're going to add some, like a cream color at the top. And we're going to go ahead and take the one from this palette, I think. Yeah. We're going to take the one from this palette, which is this one right here. It's just a matte shade. And we're going to add it up here because we want to make it really bright up there. This one has a little bit of a point, so I'm going to go ahead and use this one. You could also use something, well, you know what? I could probably use this one. It's a little bit angled, but you can also use this one. It's fine. So I'm going to use that. And we're going to go ahead and use that angle to kind of brighten up underneath the brow. We're going to blend, so don't worry about it. Just going to apply the color here. Like this. A lot of people like to use the concealer underneath the brows, like to carve them out. And you can do that. I just like to just do it with eyeshadow. You could do it however you want. That's just preference. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and use this brush because I didn't get to use it. So I'm going to go ahead and use this one. It's completely clean, but I am going to go into this lighter brown shade that I told you that I wanted to use, but I ended up using this darker one right here for the transition shade. So I'm going to use that light one and tap off all the excess, and I'm going to blend all the top part, okay? So we're going to go ahead and take this light one and then just blend up here. Blend all the top part. This. Okay, like that. And then we're going to take this brush right here that we used at the very beginning, and we're going to go ahead and blend these shadows. I'm going to add a tiny bit of product from the first transition shade we used, and we're going to go in here and we're going to blend these shadows right here. Just a lot of blending. Lots of blending. Okay. I feel like I lost a little bit of the green, so I'm going to go back into the green. So, we're going to go back into the Vice palette and get some green. And just add a tiny bit more, just so we don't lose it. Because of all the blending that we did with the browns, you kind of lose the green a little bit. So I got to go back into that. We're going to use this brush right here and just add a little bit of green. Like this. Because I don't want to lose the green. Back in here. And kind of feel like it still needs a little bit of darkness here, guys. So I might add a little bit of a dark, I don't want to use black because I already did that. So I might just go back into the brown and just intensify it a little bit. But I'm going to do it with this brush. Same one that I used with the green. Just going to clean it off. And I'm going to add some of that dark brown right here. Just to make it a little bit more bold. See? And I just want to intensify this little part right here. See how I just made it a little bit darker than on this side? It does a little something, you know? So, definitely need to do that. Okay. So, I think I'm fine with that. I'm going to go ahead and clean off this part right here. Just so we can have a really sharp area right here, like that. So now we have a really sharp edge. Okay, now we're going to work on the bottom part. And I want to go ahead and use that green that I told you. And I'm going to go back into that same brush that I just used the dark brown with. And I'm going to add the green at the bottom. And then I'll add some brown to it. This is a different color green. This is more of like a forest green. And just connect it right here. This is a good brush to like smudge with. See, there's that green. See how it looks a little bit different than the top one? But it's still a beautiful green. I'm going to add a little bit more just to make it a little bit darker. Green is actually one of my favorite colors, guys. Purple and green are some of my favorite colors. Okay, so we're going to go back into the brown that we went ahead and used in the crease area. And we're going to add it right underneath, right here. Just to make it a little bit darker. So that's what it looks like so far. I still have to add the mascara. I'll still do a little bit more blending there at the top. I feel like I still need to blend a little bit more and add a little bit more of that red brown color. I feel like right here I'm kind of missing a little bit. So let me add a little bit right here. A little bit over here. You always gotta go back and make sure that everything is the way you want it. Like this. Okay, I have to really take off the little hairs because they're driving me insane. Okay, so I have this little pen right here. You can get this on Amazon. It's like under $10. At least when I purchased it, it was under $10, and I just got myself dirty. Got some of that green on there. It's fine. Clean it up. That's why the sponge is so great, because you can correct with it. Okay, so let me make sure I don't have any green on my hands. I take this little pen, and we're just going to clean up our brows. Super easy. Like if you totally forgot to do your eyebrows, this is such an easy way to clean up. If you need to trim any little hairs, you can. I should have done this before I applied my shadows, but it's fine. You can still do it. Make sure everything's nice and clean, especially for the pictures. Okay, so there you go. There's that. Nice and clean now. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and add some mascara. I'm trying to look for it. Here it is. You guys will see it come more together, and I still have to use the eyeliner. I'm going to show you the eyeliners that I brought out, and I need to put a highlight on the inner corner. Oh, A lot of people like to use the liquid liner. I can't do that. I don't like it. I always mess up. I don't like to do it. So what I can do is add some shadow just to give it a little bit more of some darkness, so it kind of looks like I'm wearing false lashes. And I'll just show you how I do that real quick. Let me just apply the mascara and I'll show you. Okay, so always do the bottom lashes like that. And then we're going to go ahead and add some black shadow. And I'm going to take the one from this palette. Got to use these eyeshadows up, guys. They're just sitting in my closet. And I gotta use them. Haven't done makeup in a long time. And I gotta get back into it. I gotta finish these shadows. So many new shadows have come out, and I'm still with my older ones. I honestly feel like I'm completely out of the loop. It's like so many. I used to know all the latest eyeshadow palettes and everything, and no, not anymore. I'm so out of it. It's okay. You can always get back into it. Okay, here we go. See? Just kind of makes it look better. Let me bring it in. And now it looks like we got a little bit of a wing liner. It's just better for more mature skin to use eyeshadows versus the liquid. It's just a little bit more subtle. It's not so, the liquid is a little bit, I feel like, more for the younger kids, the younger women, not kids, women. Hold on, because mature skin has a little bit more lines, and you got to be careful. I got a lot more lines than I used to, so it is what it is. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit out here. To kind of give it like a little wing. And then on this side. Okay, so I think that's good. I'm going to go ahead and add the green liner in the waterline. These videos are really long, guys, but hopefully you guys have time to watch them. If you're working, don't do it. But if you aren't and you're at home and you're enjoying your Thanksgiving, watch my videos. Share them if you can. Hi, Holly. Oh, thank you. How is your... I'm using this one. This one's from Avon, guys. This is a green one. How's your Thanksgiving vacation going? Rihanna's really just been playing games. She was making bracelets, but she's been playing games lately. And Rem has just been on the phone with his friends. Just chilling. Aw, thank you. I love green. It's one of my favorite colors. Actually, for my wedding, I had green. I had green flowers. My makeup was green. I had green. My sister did my makeup for my wedding. Okay, so there's the green, and that's the green liner, the waterline. Every time I add eyeliner, my eyes want to cry. Okay, so I'm going to leave it like that for a little bit. If I need to come back and add some more mascara, I'll do it. But for right now, I think that's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and go in with this Jane bronzer. I like this one because it's got a little bit of a red tone to it. A lot of people like it to be more of a brown, which is more contour. This is like more of a contour. This is darker. See how this one has a little bit more red to it? But I like to use this one more. But I have used this one a lot, and I'll show you the difference. But for right now, I'm going to go ahead and use this one. Look for my sponge. Okay, so I'm going to do this with a wedge. No brushes. I love using brushes, but I honestly just sold all my face brushes and just started using wedges. So I'm going to go a little bit higher than you would normally put it, which is right down here. I put it up here because it kind of like lifts the face. So it doesn't look more like saggy. I saw that in a video and I was like, you know what? It does make a huge difference. So instead of putting it down here like I always would, I'm putting it up higher, and it seems to make a huge difference. And this just kind of brings some color back to my face. So I like to do this. And you can see that it kind of lifts the face a little bit more instead of me putting it down here. So that's just a little trick I got from these youngsters. You always learn. You can always learn new tricks. So there's this, and it just kind of makes the face look slimmer. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and go around the face because we need some color on here. I'm going to go on here and just go around. Like this. Here. And I like to add a little bit more just because for camera, because it kind of washes me out because of the lighting. I add a little bit more just for camera purposes. But then after the video, if I need to tone it down, I'll just take my sponge that I used to apply my foundation and I will just tone it down a little bit because I don't want to go out looking all crazy with too much bronzer. So this is the J-Lo trick, where you kind of just add a little bit of bronzer here. And it's really, I feel like it's more for camera purposes. Like this. So I'm going to leave it like that. I think it looks good for right now. I'll show you just the difference with this contour shade. I'll use the other side of the sponge. And this is the shade it gives. So I'm going to add a tiny bit right here. Just very, very lightly. You can see the difference, I think, in tones. And it actually makes it look like more... the face looks slimmer. See how it created that shadow? Look at the difference between this side and this side. So if you add that contour, it gives you the illusion that your face is slimmer. See? Why didn't I do this before? I've always contoured, guys. I just never did it with both of these. Why was I always doing it lower? see my face would simmer now. Just barely, barely tapping. But I still love that other red shade. The red shade is really, really pretty. I really like that one. Okay, so that's what it looks like so far. Now we're going to go ahead and add the blush. I'm going to add this one from e.l.f. And I had told you that I didn't like this one at first because it felt really greasy. And I was like, no, I'm going to break out from that. But I actually really, really like it. And it's actually really affordable. When I used it yesterday, I was like, this is actually really pretty. So, but when I first tried it, it wasn't that great, guys, honestly. But it is a really beautiful shade. You'll see right now. I used this one yesterday. And I really loved the way it looked. And you can just apply it with your finger, or you could use the sponge, whatever you want. I'm just doing it with my finger. But you can do it with the sponge. You can smile and get all the little areas right here. It's just really pretty. It's just like a really subtle shade, and I love it. Now, yesterday I did top it off with this one, which this one's compared, this e.l.f. Duo is compared to like the NARS. The NARS duo that they have, I believe the blush is called Orgasm, and I just went ahead and topped it off with that, and it looks really pretty with that one topped. You don't have to. Normally people just use it like that, but it's really pretty when you set it, see? But I like the dewy look, so sometimes I don't set unless it's like a special occasion or whatever, then I'll set it. You see how pretty that is? Together, they're so beautiful. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and leave it like that. And now we're gonna go ahead and go into the lips, which is one of my favorite parts. okay, so yesterday I showed you this one, and I was like, well, maybe with this look and the green, maybe it'll look pretty. So I brought this one out. I have this burgundy purpley shade, and I'm not even sure if I'm going to like it. I just took it out because I wasn't really sure. And then I have this one that is really, really pretty, and I think it would look really nice with all the different brown nudes that I have here that you guys have seen me use. And the last one I have is this NYX, which is like a pinky shade and just a brown lipstick to go around. So I'm just like not really sure what to do, because I love lipsticks. So I think what we're gonna do is I'll go ahead and start with the maroon shade, which the burgundy shade, which I think is gonna be too much for the look, because I already have a lot going on my eyes. But I'm gonna show it to you anyway, just so you can see it. This is from Avon. This one I got a while back. And it just, it's like a burgundy shade. Honestly, I think it's going to be a lot, but I'm just going to try it just for you guys. Now, we could tone it down. You guys know that I love to combine lipsticks. And when I combine lipsticks, I create some really pretty shades. And I'm like barely touching my lips with this lipstick because it's so intense. I know it's too much. It's too much, but see, if I go darker, it'll be really dark. So it is a beautiful shade. If you like these kind of shades, Avon has this really pretty one. But me personally, I don't really like really bold shades like this. I feel like it makes me look a little bit older. But in pictures, you guys seem to really like the way they look. So I went ahead and brought, like I said, these other shades. I have the one I've been using a lot lately, which is the Naked one from Milani, which is in the number 89. And then I have this one, which is Matte Naked, which is 61. So those are some really pretty shades that I really like, and we can actually mix with this to kind of tone it down. So I'm just going to use the Naked one that I've been using lately. It's just like a brown. Well, you know what? No. We'll use the Matte Naked because it's a little bit more nude to tone it down and see what we think about that shade. And if not, we can always switch it to a brown. See, that one I can wear. That one is really pretty, and I really like that one. And I can actually top it off with this lip gloss from NYX. See, that one is really pretty. That one I can do. I think that one's really wearable, and I think it'll go really great. I just need to straighten my hair, put on the jewelry, and you guys will see it come together. I really like this one. I can do a brown one so you guys can see, but I don't think I've done one like this. I think this one's really pretty. I actually kind of want to keep it, guys. But I want to show you the brown one too. So I guess I can just take it off for right now. And I might keep this one though. So we're going to go ahead and take it off, just so I can show you a brown and see what you guys think. Okay, let's try a brown. So, yesterday I showed you this shade, okay? This one definitely is super bright on its own, but I feel like it's gonna be too brown. And yesterday I just couldn't do it. It also tingles my lips. And I don't know if that's to like kind of give it a plumping effect. So I feel like it's too much brown already. But it is really pretty. What do you guys think? This one or the other one? I kind of like the other one more, but I kind of want to hear what you guys have to say. I'm going to put this lipstick around. It's just a darker, it's an Urban Decay dark lipstick. I should have put the other lipstick on first, but it glides better with the lip gloss. What do you think about that one? That one's really pretty. See, I feel the tingling effect. Oh, I thought my lipstick was gonna fall. What do you guys think? That one's really pretty too. I haven't done one this dark. What do you guys think? Is it nice? That one's pretty too, guys. I just, the tingling effect. I like it, but I kind of like the other one more. Okay, so the last combo would be just pink. And try this one here. See what those do. And maybe with the Naked. We can try those out and see what we think. But this one's pretty, but it's just the tingling is just a little annoying, honestly. I don't really like the tingling effect it has. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and do this one. I'm going to put the Naked one first. This shade. Yeah. which is a really beautiful shade, and I really like that one too. I always use like nude lips. Hubby really likes it when I use nude lips. And so I have this one. Like I said, I know I got this one on with Sephora, but I'm not really sure what brand it is. Okay, that one's a little intense. It is really pretty. But I feel like it does need a little bit of darkness because I feel like it's too... So I might add a little bit of this one, which is from Urban Decay. I like that one too, guys. Not really sure. I could do this and add a hint of that purple, which is, I'm telling you, I like to combine colors. So I'm going to add a tiny bit and see what it does. Just right here in the center. I like that one. I think that one's really pretty. I think I'm going to keep this one. I know I do a lot of nudes, but I really like that one. I think I'm going to keep that one. Hopefully you guys like it. Okay, so I kind of want to intensify the brown a little bit on the eyes. But I want to add mascara first and see if just the mascara is enough. So let's go ahead and add some more mascara. I need another mascara, guys. This one's already drying out on me. I haven't bought one in a while. I need to get one. We still need to add the inner corner highlight, which I forgot to do. I just saw right now and I'm like, I need to do the inner corner. I know I said I was going to do the inner corner, so I need to do it. I'm going to go ahead and use this one right here in the Cinnamon Swirl palette. I like that one. Hopefully it shows up pretty. This is the shade right here. And you guys know I like to go up with it. Like that. The inner corner highlight does make a difference. And I just go up with it. You guys can see that. That. And then let me just blend one more time up there. Where is that brush? Where's my brush? This one right here. Okay, so that is what it looks like. I need a highlight to put on the cheek, and let me see if there's one here that I can use. probably use, I didn't bring one out this time, so I'm just going to use an eyeshadow. You can do it with the eyeshadow. I really like the way this looks right here, so I can get away with that. And hopefully it comes out pretty. There's this one. And then the other one that I could probably use is this one. But I kind of like the one we used right here. So I might just do that one. Just to show you a different... See that? You could just do it with the eyeshadow. You don't have to buy a separate highlight. And some right here, and I'll just put some right here. I usually just do this for special occasions, but just put some right there. Okay, so that's what the makeup look looks like. Hopefully you guys like it. So I'm gonna do my hair. I'm just gonna straighten it out. I haven't done any of that in any of the videos, so I'm gonna go ahead and do it just because I have the time to do it right now. So let me just plug this in. This is, actually, I bought this Infinity Pro from Sally's a long time ago. And it's actually a really great, hold on, let me get under my desk. A long time ago. And I love it because it, it heats up real fast. So it has like, four settings, I think. It goes up to 425. And you can put it up. So, let me just show you. So it goes up to, yeah. See? It has like four settings. But once you put it there, it like heats up in like a few seconds. It's like so fast. And for today's perfume, I'm going to go ahead and use this one from Tease, from Victoria's Secret. It's the Tease. My daughter loves it when I wear this, and she likes to wear it, too. It's just such a great perfume. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and do... I'm going to go ahead and do my hair. Just going to straighten it out. I've been trying not to straighten so much because I don't want to be burning my hair all the time. So I've just been kind of blow drying. But for today... I'm going to go ahead and straighten it. Just because I really love green. And I'm excited. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And then we'll put the jewelry at the very end. I'll put the jewelry. And I'll show you how fast this is. With this Infinity Pro. It's so fast. Like, it's super hot right now. See how fast that was? I usually go over it, like, two times. But, like, it's at 400 right now. And look at how fast that was. See? I'd have this to this. So, I'm going to do it one more time. And I never use a brush for this. I just do it like this. Like that. See how straight that is? So I'm like done really fast. Okay, so I think that what takes the longest is the top part, only because of my bangs, because I like them a certain way. I don't remember how much I paid for this one, but it was a long time ago, so prices probably changed. But you can find it at Sally's. At least that's where I got mine. I have bought one downtown, but I ended up giving that one to my niece, because for some reason when I would use it, like it would like make my head itch after straightening my hair, like after like, I don't know, just throughout the day it would just like make my head itch. I don't know if it was the plates or what. Okay. my hair is getting really long. I'm going to go ahead and let it grow more. So let's do the top part. Okay. So normally what I do is I just pull it to the front. This is not good when you're wearing lip gloss. But I'm just going to go ahead and do it anyway. I honestly wanted to put my hair in layers, but then I'm like, no, it took me a long time to get rid of my layers, so I'll just keep it like this for now. But sometimes I miss my layers in the front, like to face frame. So I'm just going to straighten it out like this. Super easy. This side. See how easy that was. But I'm still going to do my bangs one more time because sometimes even though I do them, they still stay a little wavy. I don't like go section for section. I don't have the patience to do that. I just take a big old chunk of hair and just do it. I know it's not the proper way to do it, but I just don't have a lot of patience. Unless I'm going to a wedding, then I'll take my time. Or like a quinceañera or something, then I'll take my time. But other than that, I just do it like this. Just straighten it. And I go over it a few times just to make sure it's super straight. And what I like to do is I like to go over the bangs a little bit and then go like this to the side. See how pretty that looks? So then I do this side. See how easy that was with the straightener? It's so fast. So when I'm always rushing before church, like to get dressed, if I straighten my hair, like if hubby's like already here, like I could just do my hair like in 5 minutes. Like it just takes 5 minutes. And I have a lot of hair. But this thing is really great. You just don't want to do it all the time. You don't want to burn your hair so much. There's that. Now we're going to turn that off because we don't want to burn our hair anymore. And I don't want to get burned. So we're going to turn that off and I'm going to put it here to the side. And I'm just going to put on the jewelry now. Usually I like to do the top part. Hold on. I forgot to do this part. I always do this part at the very end. Just to make sure it's like super straight from the back. And I forgot to do that. And it's still hot, so I can still use it. Okay. Okay, so that's what that looks like. See how it came together? And I think that really pretty purple just gave it a little something. Okay, so now I'm going to put the jewelry on that I was telling you about that I haven't worn and that my sister had given me. a while back. She was like, it's gonna look pretty on you, and I was like, no, it's too much. But honestly, it is a really beautiful piece. So this one's actually dedicated to her for giving me this. Okay, so here are the earrings. The earrings are super simple. Just gonna put them on real quick. They look like that. They're super simple. You can use them on their own. Like, I could just use that, and I'm like, you know, pretty simple. But this one's actually going to all my friends at the nursing home so that they can see that I remember them, because they used to be such dolls, and they used to always wear really beautiful jewelry, and they're the ones that actually got me into all the jewelry and all that. So, okay, so I know that this shirt is really not for that, but it is a really beautiful piece, and it's like the only green I have in my closet to wear with this piece. But obviously you could wear it with something else. See? But I wanted to go ahead and show you a little bit of fashion jewelry and what it would look like. So we can part the hair this way. And sometimes it wants to give me a hard time because I'm always using it in the center. We could put it to the side like that. What do you guys think, guys? I'm gonna go ahead and change the lighting so you guys can see it in a different lighting. Hold on, let me find, where's the button? So this is like a yellow, and then this is no lighting. This is what I would look like. Sorry guys, I messed with something and I don't know, it took me somewhere else. Okay, so this is the look. It has a really cute little heart right there. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the look. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys like the lipstick, did you guys like the first one? I really liked the first one too, and I would have kept it, but I wanted to try something a little bit different. So hopefully you guys like this one too. I think it was really pretty. It is like a nude, and I wanted to give you guys something different, but I'm a little scared when it comes to, I like color in my eyes, but sometimes my lips are just, okay, so I'll add a little bit more in the center, like that, and yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you guys like the green, if you like lips, what you guys like, did you guys like the jewelry, all right. Thanks for watching. I know it was a long video, but I really wanted to do my hair for this video so you guys could see how fast it was with that Infinity Pro from Sally's. And hopefully you guys liked all the makeup products. Let me know which eyeshadows were your favorite, or which eyeshadow palette was your favorite. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Thanks for watching, guys. And thanks for all the love and support and liking of the pictures and everything. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.